Thank you. us the gate of everlasting life. Grant that we who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth, for you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When God, who is your life, is revealed, then you will also be revealed with him in glory. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Standing beside this flowering cross, because we know he Here at St. Paul's, we still need Jesus Christ to save us. In our era, it isn't fashionable to proclaim that Jesus is the only way the world can be saved. We're Episcopalian Christians, after all. We like actions better than words. And besides, maybe we haven't really bought that Christocentric party line about perfect love being revealed in the eternal Son God sent to redeem the whole world. Perhaps we came to church today to hear exquisite music and sing our favorite hymns. Maybe we wanted to watch the little ones rustling up those hidden eggs in the Skilling's garden. Whatever our individual reasons for being here this morning, God has a deeper intention behind that Sunday serendipity. I believe heaven is calling you and me, each and every one of us, to that deeper, truer life of abundant joy that cannot be shaken by life's changes and chances, that cannot be undone, even by death itself. God's risen life is the mystery of love we celebrate this morning. Jesus willingly shared this eternal love with the whole world and overcame every obstacle that stands in its way so that we might hear the voice of love calling us each by name. Yes, Easter should command our attention, no matter how conflicted we may feel responding to heaven's call. Jesus deserves our answer. He more than loved us to the moon and back, as we're so fond of saying that we do for one another. No, Jesus went to hell and beyond just to redeem us. And Jesus believes that we deserve to know the difference God's love will make in our lives. For God adores and seeks out every single one of us. God will not stop calling until we answer. On the peninsula, and here at St. Paul's, we spend a fair amount of time and energy living like we have everything we need, or at least trusting that we know the way to obtain it. We lead meaningful lives full of purpose, joy, and beauty. We are people of courage and consequence, whose impact makes a difference for others. But recent years of turmoil, uncertainty, and loss, including all that 2023 has brought here to the Bay Area, all of these things have revealed that even our most Herculean efforts will still sometimes amount to things which end in death. And we need what Christ offers us. This is why we are here this morning. The rousing Easter wake-up call from our Gospel of Matthew was nothing like that mild tremor out of Pacifica a few weeks ago. Did you feel that little one? It shook me awake. No, the ancient earthquake that we heard about in Matthew, it shook the earth's foundations as the angel rolled back the stone from the entrance to Jesus' tomb. It was earth's harbinger of that vaster seismic shift in the universe to which Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were invited to bear witness when they arrived in that place at daybreak. And that seismic shift still shakes the world with its power. For that magnificent call from heaven, the likes of which had never before been heard, called those two women to step forward in faith into the greater reality of God's risen life. Interestingly, these women don't speak a word in this story. This might be good news for us, huh? But they do obey the heavenly messenger's instructions, even in their confusion and fear. worship at his feet with sighs and prayers too deep for words, as the risen Jesus turns their fears to joy with the loving reality of his presence. As we think about their experience this morning, I wonder, what breathtaking ways does love's consequential invitation come flashing into our lives? We might not see an angel amid all the quaking of our world. With the many successive lightning flashes these past few years, a deadly pandemic, global war, economic uncertainty, atmospheric rivers, bank insolvencies, corporate layoffs, it would only be natural to start to numb out instead of sit with that fear and worry. But the presence of love draws near to us this morning, calling us to follow Jesus' steady voice as he sends us to go, tell, and see all God is raising to new life. Amid these many storms we have been enduring,
died in the faith of Christ.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us join in saying together our prayer for mission.
Gracious and loving God, help us this day to understand and celebrate your freedom of the world, to be transformed in Jesus' love, and to use our gifts to make a difference for others. Amen.
Let us commend the world in which Christ rose from the dead, in our whole lives, to the mercy and protection of God, trusting in the love that frees us from fear and sends us forth, recreated through the grace of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We come to the table in his name and share Christ's peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Last night. that we are all able to walk in love together with our Lord Jesus Christ. So let us walk in love, as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice for the whole world.
Thank you.
your blessing and fed us with your constant love. You have redeemed us in Jesus Christ and knit us into one body. Through your Spirit, you replenish us and call us to fullness of life. Therefore, joining with angels and archangels and with the faithful of every generation, we lift our voices with all creation as we sing.
Stay.
poverty, sickness, selfishness, war, and greed, that the new creation in Jesus Christ may appear in justice, love, and peace, to the glory of your name, and the blessing of Almighty God,